video where they said that nigga looked like a calf strain?
Yes.
He looked like a muscle spasm. That shit looked nasty.
He looked
No. Benzino dead looked like a costume design for like some kind of futuristic alien movie.
No, wow.
He got his body augmented. Like, that nigga looked crazy.
He thinks it's sexy.
Yo.
somebody like it. Somebody like it. You know what I'm saying? Somebody.
Someone said, oh, he got more neck than I thought he did. And I was done.
Why y'all killing Benzino, man, the Boston legend?
Hey, yo, we recording, man. My name is Michael Beasley, for those of you who may not have forgotten. That's Kent M, for those who may have forgotten. And that's Ash, for those who may have forgotten. This is episode 40 of Beasley Zounds Podcast. We've been gone for a break. We've been dealing with these cicadas. We've been infested.
Cicadas?
Yeah, we've been dealing with them. I don't know where you've been.
I ain't seen nary a cicada, bro.
That's because they're not here. They're there in his part, though. Like what Vaughn said this morning, he showed me his windshield. That thing, he hit all of them. Bro. And he said it was only through like DC, Maryland. So,
nigga, I almost crashed the other day.
Yeah.
Yo, flew in the whip on my face.
Oh.
Crashed.
Okay.
I probably would.
They scared to come outside over here. That's.
That's what I did. That's what I did in the car. Slapped myself. Yeah, it was bad. It was bad. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You doing all of that?
I've been dealing with that. You know what I'm saying? I've been a homosexual for a little while. You know what I'm saying? Just trying to find somewhere to live. But we're going to get that right pretty soon. Don't worry.
He did say hobo, guys.
Yeah, hobo. 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 As in, like, all my belongings are in a bag tied to a stick that I just carry along.
You got all your shit in a napkin.
In a napkin.
His whole life was in a bandana.
That's it. That's it. In a kerchief. That's it. In a kerchief, as they say. You know. But other than that, I've just been watching these playoffs, man. Watching these NBA playoffs, dog.
Yeah, man. Steph,
no LeBron. Yo, no, but this has been we watching the new, the change in the guard. We watching the new young niggas come up.
Oh, yeah?
I've been loving this shit.
Oh, yeah?
All right, sorry. My fault. Let's get it out the way now. I want to give a big congrats to the New York Knickerbockers, you know what I'm saying, on a very successful season. Fourth seed in the Eastern Conference. Niggas didn't even think we was going to get in there.
You're 2 years too early.
Congrats to Julius Randle, most improved player.
No congrats.
I'm giving absolutely no shout out to RJ Barrett. It's a 6'6" trash can. Big ups to Derrick Rose. You know what I'm saying? That nigga found the fountain of youth in them dreads. So big up to him. Big ups to Quick. Big ups to Toppin. Hope y'all niggas come back stronger.
I'll talk to them too.
Alfred Payton.
Wait a minute. Me and you saying very differently on that, bro. You congratulating Julius Randle. Nigga had 7 turnovers. Didn't want to shoot the ball. And
he had a good regular season, man.
So who the fuck what?
I don't want to do this. I don't want to do this because I fuck with Julius and I feel like he's going to come back better from this. This is his first playoffs ever.
That was a lot of people's first playoffs.
I know that. It was his first playoffs.
There was 2 people that had been in the playoffs other than the rest of the team. 2 people.
Yeah, I don't know. What the rest of the team really do, though? What's the team?
I don't know.
The only players that really showed up for us were niggas that had been there before. When you think about it,
Taj Gibson and
Derrick Rose. That was it. Consistently through all 6 of them games. Consistently, that's all we was getting.
Listen, I don't want to relive this. Fuck Atlanta. Fuck Ice Trey. Fuck y'all fake Atlanta niggas, bro. Y'all niggas only like Atlanta because of the fucking Migos, my nigga. Word. That ass, nigga. That's it. That's all. I got Ken calling me on the phone. I straight kill it. Bro, you like the Migos, though. You don't care about basketball. My nigga, don't call me with that bullshit. Because I'm a nigga. Y'all niggas do a lot of hating on New York, bro. That nigga, anybody want BS? That's all. That's all.
That's all it is. That's all it is. That's straight. We gonna get Dame next season.
Yeah, Zion in another season after that.
Right.
Shouts out to Loopy. Loopy back out there. I mean, I see them on Side Talk NYC. Loopy back in the mix. So you already know. You already know. But I'm gonna get off. I'm gonna get off that.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get off that high real quick.
Nah, but the thing is, yo, all hope is not lost, man. The Nets are still in the playoffs.
Fuck the Nets.
They about to win the chip.
No, they not.
Who going to win that? Niggas.
Nah, if it's like, if you believe that changing of the guard shit,
yeah,
it is going to be Philly and Utah.
Yo, Utah look, they looking good as shit.
That's what I think is
going to be. Looking good. Nah, but all right. So, let's talk about it. Let's go through it. You know what I'm saying? Utah, Memphis, dog. What was your biggest takeaways from that jump? Like, what did you learn after watching that shit? This is the first time getting to watch a lot of these teams. You know what I'm saying?
John Morant will be leaving Memphis in 2 years.
I think so.
That's my biggest takeaway.
I don't see that.
I see it.
Honestly, you know what I see? Look, well, you know what? If they don't get a third guy with them, because I don't think that Jaren Jackson nigga is going to be, or Valanciunas is that third guy. But if they get a third guy, yo, that's a scary team right there. They can win the chip, bro. Yes, they can. Watch. And that dude, Dylan Brooks, that's an all-star next year. Watch. That will play. He could play. Evil Danny Green.
Hold on, real quick. My nigga, is your hair blue?
Nah.
All right, it was looking blue.
Oh.
All right. Yeah, nah.
I know that.
John Morant is going to leave the Grizzlies, bro.
Okay. What about with Phoenix and LA, man? Is LeBron washed? Is that it for him?
No.
This is first round series loss.
Yeah.
Do we attribute that to the fact that their team wasn't really together all year?
I would.
AD tried to go hurt when he couldn't go.
AD is the tin man, and he got a bunch of bums around him.
Nah, that team is really fucking bad, dude.
Yo, bro, they fucked up last year by letting all of those people go.
I thought the pieces that they replaced them with were upgrades.
Who told you that?
A lot of people were saying Dennis Schroeder was an upgrade, yes. And they were also saying that Montrezl Harrell was an upgrade. Montrezl Harrell was sixth man of the year last year.
And so what?
That's a coaching problem. He didn't get on the court. Why is Marcus playing more than him?
I don't know, bro.
It's a good question.
People don't work in systems, bro. LA may be done. I don't think LeBron done. LeBron can still get his fifth one. It's still LeBron James, bro. Come on. And this is going to be a weird-ass finals, not having LeBron and or Steph Curry playing.
Yeah.
That's our first time in 10 years.
I mean, how much of this do you think the bubble had to do with this and, like, the shortened season? And
a lot.
Because LA's repeating if they have a regular offseason, right?
Yeah, hell yeah.
Okay, all right. I don't see them beating them if they're healthy. That's what I'm saying. Like, their defense was too fucking good when they were off.
Yeah, but then
Devin Booker said Devin Booker a murderer.
Yeah, I fuck with D Book. That's it. I don't care for Chris Paul.
What about Kyrie, man? What's your feelings on Kyrie now, man? He got an end still?
No.
Nah.
I don't get. I'm mad.
You don't know, hear he's not banging with Kyrie?
I said no. I never was.
Nah.
Kyrie good because LeBron was good.
What?
He was a sort of. He was nice, but he was still on a bum team. Then he thought he was too big for it. Left LeBron. All right, you go to Boston. You stink it up there. All right. Mm. And you go to now you in Brooklyn. You stink it up there. He's wild. I'm sorry. I'm outside, everybody.
Sorry. In Brooklyn, Richmond right now.
But he in Brooklyn, right? Yeah. He's still stinking up there, too.
How?
Stinking. James Harden is the only person that wants it.
Okay. KD.
Nah, I don't even think KD the same player. I don't care what this, what I see. I don't think he's the same player. I don't think he can do what he used to be able to do. I'll shut up. I'll take this point away if they win, and I don't think that they win it.
I don't know, man. I don't see what team is stopping them at this point.
They got two very hard teams that they're going to have to play next. I'm going to tell you that right now.
I get it.
Milwaukee been together.
But when the shots start falling, because all these niggas do is shoot threes now. That's the whole league. The whole league is outside shots.
Once I have
falling, Nets are beating everybody, dog.
I had enough of the three league.
Me too. I'm sick of this shit, honestly.
Bro, playoff game ended playoff game ended like 144 to like 114. I was like, yo, bro.
It's the National Blowout Association, bro.
Yeah, nobody's playing defense, bro. Come on, what am I watching?
Nigga, who the fuck is Bryn Forbes?
Who?
Exactly. This nigga's hitting 7 threes a game from Milwaukee. Who the fuck is Bryn Forbes?
I don't know.
That's what I'm saying. Like, this is crazy, yo. Man.
Listen,
we need a traditional back to the basket player that just dominates. We need more Jokic's.
Yeah, Jokic.
We need more of him.
Need more of those.
We need a black Jokic.
Nah, I want Jokic to be a hero and dominate everybody. What I really want to see is somebody get clothesline from shooting the three.
We need another Anthony Mason in the NBA.
Now, yeah, remember how you're not gonna get into the paint? I'm gonna clothesline you. And you had to be scared to get in the paint? That's
yo, they've been calling the most ticky-tack bullshit fouls, dog. Like,
so what?
They've been calling the most bullshit fouls, bro. There's no playoff basketball being played. This is ridiculous.
Because nobody getting crazy and knocking a nigga out. Knock niggas out, bro. I want to see somebody bleed. It's the playoffs, bro.
All right. So now that we're talking about that, where do you stand on how the crowds have been behaving in these playoff games?
Oh, fuck them up.
Not fucking with it at all. You don't, there's no place for it.
No, it's, listen, I'm not no political, oh, this is not no place that's kids hit. Nah, start fucking them up. Start fucking them up. It's that simple.
I think so too. I agree.
I don't got nothing else to say to that.
I think that needs to happen again. Because honestly, the fucked up part is, I feel like that shit gonna happen a little bit more once next season comes around too. Because all the fans are gonna be back in total. Like, it's gonna be 100% capacity. Shit's gonna be nuts. Like,
yeah. Listen, everything's out. Everything's opening up, so people going crazy. Something's gonna happen that's gonna set the tone and calm everybody the fuck down. Like, hey, nigga, you cannot do that. Mm. Something's gonna happen. I don't know what, but
it's gonna be maybe Rolling Loud.
Rolling Loud?
Rolling Loud's probably gonna set that tone that you're thinking about.
You think so?
I do.
All right. I do.
That place has always been a disaster site. And now that we're just opening back up, and it's in LA this year, right?
Rolling Loud has like 3 different.
Are they doing 3 locations this year? Oh shit, yeah. They're doing a Miami one again, right?
Yeah. So wait.
You haven't seen what's happening in Florida recently, right?
What happened? Yeah, I was trying to understand what you were saying. So you were saying cases about to go back up.
So, never mind Corona. Gun violence is about to go. Niggas are vaccinated and they strapped.
some type of violence is gonna happen that's gonna calm society down. Like, yo, chill out, bro. I understand you happy to be outside, but guys, chill out.
I ain't gotta worry about that Coachella 2022.
So you in there? That's your wave.
Yeah.
Yo, so have you been on a plane recently? Ash?
Mm-hmm.
Any any fisticuffs on these flights? Yeah, that seems to be becoming a thing now that people are flying again.
No, that's true, but no, none of the flights I've been on have any
straight.
Any fights or anything like that. But I also didn't take anything international. I took myself to Florida.
You took yourself to Florida. What was that like?
I didn't stay on South Beach purposely. It was just, it would be too much going on for me personally. Mm-hmm. But while I am vaccinated and that's fine and everything, I'm just like, I still don't want to, I'm not ready for that quite yet. But in 2022, I will be. But yeah, no. I mean, I stayed in the area, so it was fine. I mean, it was a good amount of people out, but definitely when I went out to like brunch or a bar or something, I didn't hit any clubs, but bars were still like jumping, so.
Nah, shit back open, yo. Shit back open. Yeah. Back open.
Yeah.
Everything. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, this shit, no restrictions, shit lifted. I went to get some food the other day and sat on the door, mask optional. I was like, oh, y'all getting spicy. Okay. I like that. Still kept my shit on, but I was just getting some to-go shit. But yeah, you know.
So, how do you feel about the vaccination, though? Are y'all vaccinated?
Yes, no. I am.
Are you getting vaccinated? You don't want to be?
I mean, I think I'll get it when it becomes like, all right, it's imperative that I get this. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh. Yeah. I've just seen, you know, I've always questioned people.
Nah, just be around y'all niggas. Y'all not sick. Like, yeah, I just heard immunized with y'all niggas.
You said what?
I just heard immunized with y'all niggas. Y'all got vaccinated, y'all good.
Yeah.
That's true.
It didn't even make me
feel so happy for them.
I'm talking about outside of us, though.
You said what?
You say outside of us.
Oh, outside of us. I don't
other than me and Cam is what I'm saying.
Yeah.
You gotta take that penitentiary chance out there.
I go to jail. I go to jail.
Maybe, I don't know.
Oh, I
hope that's not the case.
Well, nah, I'm trying to go to Jamaica soon, so yeah, I'm probably gonna have to get that jump.
Yeah, bro. You're gonna be all right. You're not even gonna feel sick. I felt tired. That was it.
All right. What'd you get, Moderna?
Nah, bro.
I got Moderna.
The Zeneca?
Pfizer? Yeah, Pfizer Poppy.
All right, I see you.
Moderna Mommy.
Nah, but shit, yo, nah. What wild shit have we missed, man? That we need to touch on since we last recorded it. I feel like it's some stupid shit every other day. Like what's going on, man? I heard they turned on Damson Idris, the nigga from your man from Snowfall.
What about him?
He said, yo, ladies, why y'all just be curving niggas' texts instead of saying you don't want to text them? And then they got him out of here.
You can never get him out of here. So
yeah, he deactivated his shit.
I gotta get the fuck off Twitter, bro.
Hey man, I'm just saying this happened.
Every day everybody shows more and more how corny they are. I'm corny too, but like niggas be subbing their girlfriends like, yo, bro, you a cornball dog. What are you doing? Are you subbing your girlfriend? Like, who's that for me? Why I gotta see it?
The need to put all the information out there.
But this is the thing, nobody cares.
They think somebody cares.
Yeah, their girlfriend.
Or the side joint. The side joint gonna see that he arguing with his main joint, and then she gonna.
Okay, there it is. Secrets. The secrets. The ancient Chinese secrets have been revealed.
I don't know, man. I hate it. I hate all of it.
Yeah. What's going on? I'll make the woods, man. What's going on in Richmond, man?
I got a new car.
Oh, flip.
How's that pushing? Yeah.
AC works.
Is push the start?
Nah, dude. I traded. I wanted more space, so I just didn't get a push the start.
Is it an SUV?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, I gotta get a truck boy. Now, I'm not a truck, but
I call SUVs trucks, man. This is
cool. I'm about to get rocks from my front yard and shit like that. So like that's what
just think about it. You about to go to Lowe's?
Yeah, I'm the Lowe's poppy, bro.
Home Depot garden department, like shit.
You know how many plants we got?
God damn. Oh, all right, okay. You plant that right now.
You talking about like drama and shit like that? I don't know. I'm gonna just keep minding my business and be a curmudgeon.
Ain't no drama. I mean, like, yo, have there been any new laws passed? You know what I'm saying? Weed's about to be legal out here. You guys excited about it? You guys start growing cannabis at your house yet or not?
I'm not gonna tell you.
Because it ain't legal just yet.
Yeah, I ain't gonna tell you that. The McDonald's sign is on a tour.
Who?
The McDonald's sign, it's on a tour.
It is on a tour.
McDonald's sign is on a tour. What's
going on? McDonald's sign is just popping up in strange places.
There's somebody that has a McDonald's sign, the big ass sign.
From which McDonald's?
Who knows?
Oh wow.
We don't know, but it's been a Richmond thing. It's been on a Richmond page where it just keeps popping up everywhere.
It was in the projects at one point. It was in the P's. Then the next day it was in the back of somebody's truck. Then the next day it was in front of the Welcome to Richmond sign.
Yep.
It's just on tour.
Okay.
Okay. Just making its rounds.
You think McDonald's is doing that or is this some Richmonder?
They're not that smart.
Is it Richmonder or Richmondite?
Richmonder.
Richmonder. What about you? Man, no, nothing lit in DC, man.
Nothing at all.
That shit just opened back up for real. Like I'm about
True. I got a couple places I'm gonna go to out there too.
I'm about to go today. I was supposed to go to Bros Bar or some shit like that. I don't know.
You gonna eat a Glick today?
Never.
It's summertime.
Never.
Stop being ashamed for that.
I'm not from here. I don't eat Glicks. So that's not my thing. Why are you looking at me like you watched me consume a Glick in front of you like that?
I might have.
When?
I don't know. But I've known you for what, like 5 years now?
You know me for some time. You know what I'm saying? I'm sure you've seen me eat a burger.
I've seen you eat a Glick here and there.
When?
But you want me to go back on my mental Rolodex? I've seen
you. Did I eat a Glick at the big ass cookout? I've been to big ass cookout a few times. I was drunk, sleep under the tree. I ain't eat no Glick.
I never bet. I think, you know what? I think you ate a Glick that time when we drove up to New York.
Word.
They got a big goat and a Glick.
A big
goat. Yeah, don't disrespect me like that. Yeah, big goat.
Nah, we recovered when you with the peppers. We recovered.
No way, man. Yo, look, man. What bangs you dropped, man?
Oh, we did. A lot of people dropped recently.
I don't care
about nobody but Lloyd.
Lloyd Banks dropped. That shit was hard.
I like one song. Same with DMX album. I like one song. The Baby and What's the Name Project, trash.
I haven't listened all the way through yet, but damn.
It's 18 of the same songs.
So who new music you like?
This weekend?
Period.
I fucked with Sleepy Hollow's project. I fucked with some kid named Kindy. I liked his project. I like Color Gray shit, you know what I mean? I fucked with Kodak Black shit. I'm just going through all of that. That's everything I fucked with. Those other albums, I didn't really care for too much.
I like Kodak Black too.
Yeah, man.
I like Money Bag Yo's album.
That was cool too.
I'm not like a super Money Bag Yo fan either, so I like Money.
Yo, somebody said that he makes like shade room music, and I was like, yeah, this makes perfect sense.
Yeah, actually,
and I appreciated him more for that. Like when I saw, I was like, you know what, that's his bag. And that's the genre now, I feel like.
I could definitely shade room rapper. I could definitely see that. Hey, baby.
Quentin Gray's in there.
Stupid hot.
Yes, everybody. Melissa is going to join the podcast.
Yo.
Hey.
Where she at?
He's like, I didn't agree to that.
Yeah.
Oh, you have
to laugh? Yeah, plus, so plug it up. I'm sorry, everybody.
Nah, you good, man.
No, I'm just kidding.
Hey.
Is she joining the podcast or what?
You want to know something funny? Melissa got a bonnet.
Melissa has a bonnet. No, I'm not wearing a bonnet. I have a bonnet. Because I can't wash my hair. It's not good for your hair.
You know, so is guy, are guys wearing bonnets? Like, is that solidarity with the women? Y'all supporting that?
I'm not wearing no bonnet. That's why I have a durag.
If you had long hair, though, and you couldn't wash it every day, you wouldn't wear a bonnet?
I'll wear a durag.
Oh, okay. Fair enough. Oh,
you mushing that down underneath the durag, though?
No, you look crazy if you...
You're a psychopath putting a durag on the afro.
The durag can get wet. What do you do when you get in the shower?
Yo, we can't see her, dog.
Oh, he's got a short... He's got a small space right here.
We got the 007 cameras. That's what I'm saying. What's good?
Hey,
friend of the show. How you been?
Hey. Usual working. Work. What?
So she like your hair cut.
Oh, thank you. Cam did it.
Yes, I did. I'm a very talented individual.
I was going to ask.
Yeah, Cam, he helps me dye it because I can't see the back of my head.
Yeah.
Yo, you know what you should do, Cam? You should open up a hair salon when you just color people's hair, bro.
I'm good.
Means and more.
No.
You should do it in like a salon barbershop type of thing.
No, I'm not.
You
doing
need
that.
A barber. You know what I'm saying? Like, y'all niggas going to business, free cut.
And then get your hair dyed, and then no. Hell right. No.
And then if you leave a good tip, you get a t-shirt.
Yo, I guess you know, I swear I give this nigga a new business idea every week, and he never goes with any of these stuff.
I thought about starting a women's auto shop where it's all women and they have to wear sexy outfits. I make some shit of money, right?
But can they work on the car though?
Oh yeah, absolutely. They're not just gonna be looking, sitting around looking sexy. Yeah.
No, that's like the shit that somebody invited me to this shit. So they doing buns and basketball down here in Richmond.
Oh my god!
Yeah,
oh.
Ken, he was like, "You want to go?" I was like, "I have no desire to go to that."
I didn't even text that nigga back. Like.
I seen that shit like 3 weeks ago. And I was like, what the fuck is this? It looks disgusting, first of all. Like, if you gonna have shorty playing, can they at least look good?
Yo, can I call Tay? I think Tay might be going to that shit. I'm gonna call him real quick.
Tay's
like the lingerie football stuff.
Let me see.
Yeah, for basketball. Right. But the thing is they probably have no skill.
Maybe
you can
play football.
No Tay?
I guess he changed his number. I don't know.
What?
So wait. So they have no skill. They can barely do a layup, and they bounce the basketball like Stanley from The Office.
Yeah.
Oh no.
They're just scantily clad.
Yeah, it's stupid.
I can do it. I can play basketball.
But you play basketball.
Like I would just rather go to a strip joint. Like
right.
If that's what niggas is doing, like
I'd rather be double dribbling and shit. I don't want to see that.
Yeah, they were. Yo, you see her crossover?
No, I didn't.
She got a killer crossover, bro. Look at her step back. Yeah,
like, girl, Just the wild jiggly euro.
Yeah, stupid.
Yeah, so that's what's going on in y'all city.
Yeah, and I will not be attending.
At all.
I don't have no desire for that. Yeah,
it's episode 40, BC Towns podcast, man. We here, you know what I'm saying? We got cups on. And we got chains on. What's up, nigga? You got some AMC stock, I see.
You know?
Yes.
Go ahead.
I just want that. I just want AMC to keep going up. You know what I mean? Stun on these hoes.
No, we don't talk about money. You know I'm Italian. We don't talk about money.
Yo, so you know the new, you know the new cryptocurrency?
Huh?
You get the new crypto? The cum rockets?
That's what it's called. It's called cum rockets.
No, they call cummies.
No, I did not get cummy coin.
Nah.
Yes. You cop?
Nah. I just the thing. I was like, wait, hold up, but niggas playing around. Like it was tweeting Elon Musk, like, yo, like I got my cummies. Like, what the fuck? So I looked it up. Yeah, it's like an NFT coin or some shit.
Of course it is. Yo, NFTs is dead also, by the way.
Already?
Yeah.
Nigga, that was like 2 weeks.
It bottomed out. So
they said Paris Hilton got all the NFTs.
Of what?
She said she was on that shit for like 5 years ago.
She's lying.
Yo, Paris Hilton got bread, bro. I believe her.
Yeah, because her family's the Hiltons.
Yep.
All right. Did she lose it? Did she lose the money yet?
What does that mean?
Most people that are inherit money or grow up with money lose that shit in their adulthood because they don't know how to do nothing with it.
You know what? I'm going to challenge you.
Fuck it all up.
Hold on, I'm going to challenge you. How many people?
All of them.
All 100%. Of them?
Yeah, check the stats, nigga. Department of Labor, 100%, nigga.
Melissa is checking the stats right now. Her net worth is
$300 million.
I said she didn't fuck it up because she had all the NFTs. Are you not listening to me?
So anyways. I don't know what the fuck you talking about, man. But yeah, I'm not getting cummy coins.
Oh, all right.
No, what is the traded value at though right now?
I didn't look at the numbers.
You just seen?
I saw a shot up like 100-some% or some shit like that on one of these platforms. I don't know. I'm just kidding, dude.
Yeah, crypto's almost dead too. So.
Already?
Yeah. It's about time.
I don't know. I seen that nigga Samson. He said that shit good money.
Yeah. James is going to say that because he has more Bitcoin than all of us. Are you shitting me? That shit went down to 39,000. He's still good.
He said, yeah, go ahead. Keep going, bro. Keep buying.
So it's a wrap.
Yeah, that shit done, yeah.
It's plummeting every day.
That shit done.
Damn, so I should go and sell mine.
It's only going up to like 50 cents at the most. And then it go back down to like 20. Just flush
it. I'm gonna try to wait.
It'll probably do something crazy again at the end of the summer, maybe.
Wait, what'd you say, Ash?
I said when it goes back up to 50, I guess that's when I'll do my thing.
$2.50?
No, you said it goes
up to 50 cents.
And it goes down.
Yeah. Oh, it's here,
man.
Yeah. I'm done. 90
degrees here in DC.
Look, it's
hot as fuck. Dumb hot. I'm trying to go sit
on the roof.
Would it be hot outside?
Yes. No shade. I have my shades on.
You know what? You guys all know that I don't like the beach, and I would like to go to the beach today.
Fuck yeah.
Let's
go.
Wow. That's the first first, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm not saying I want to be there all day.
All the years I've known this nigga, you the said fifth. Beach the beach.
On June 5th, 2021.
He just wants to walk with his Tims in the sand. That's
Can
it.
You please, listen, please just record. Just document that entire experience, please.
Just take the toes in the sand. I just want to see.
Just record that. Because he's going to go and have a great time. He's going to go frolic in the sand.
You want to go frolic?
Yeah, I know what you want to do. You're going to build a sand castle. You're going to go get a football.
The only time this beach was lit is when drinks was being bought to me.
We were in Mexico.
That was lit. But I'm gonna go to the beach today, but it's only gonna last for maybe 10 minutes.
What beach are you going
to? I'm not going to one. I would just like to go to one.
You gonna go to this nigga go to Jones Beach, what?
Jones Beach? Fuck at it. Step on a needle.
Facts, yeah.
Damn.
Get a hermit crab.
And a dirty diaper.
Yeah, or
damn.
Oh, Ash, you ever been to Jones Beach?
No, and I know I don't want any parts from what the fuck y'all just said.
No, nah, you don't want to go to no New York beaches.
Shout out to all my Dominican people that eat spaghetti on at Jones Beach. That's true. It's a true thing.
I might hit up my friend's food truck. I don't know.
Oh, Dev? Man, shout out to Dev, man. We got to tell Dev to come on the pod one time. Come talk about the food truck. Because she ended up opening that joint.
Yeah.
And so have you supported yet?
Well, I attempted to when she first had it at her crib, but it was OD long. Like when I got out there, I thought the food was gonna be made already. And then what happened was they got it a little bit later, but we had other shit to do that day, so we couldn't. Oh,
is it good? What type of food she does?
She hasn't tried it yet.
It's called Land and Sea.
It's called what?
Land and Sea.
Land and Sea. What's she doing? Like surfing turfs.
So, you know, they have chicken, fry fish, mac, collards, shit like that.
All right. Oh, soul food truck. That's fire.
So today they're in Ashland till like 4. So okay. I may go.
All right, we're yeah. I gotta come support next time I'm down there.
Yeah.
We gotta sit out the show. But yo, that's really shit I was cracking. Like, y'all, like, other than like this whole like humanitarian crisis going on in Israel, y'all been keeping up with that shit? Yeah. Like, Israel and Palestine.
Yeah, free Palestine. That's all I got.
Yeah.
They're doing the people's criminal.
Yeah, that shit is crazy. Like, imagine somebody coming into your house and being like, "This is my house now."
Right.
Like, you know.
Right. Right. So you guys aren't confused. Have you guys been seeing like what's been going on in like Ethiopia recently?
Where?
In Ethiopia, in Africa.
I just read that they just banned Twitter over there.
Nah, that was in Nigeria or Ghana, I think. Or
oh, Nigeria.
Nigeria, I think. I'm not exactly sure.
Well, what's happening there?
Well, I don't know exactly what's going on in Nigeria, but the president tweeted something and Twitter deleted it. So as a result, they banned and the platform's use in Nigeria.
Well, what did he tweet?
I have no idea. Like I literally, like, this is something I just saw in passing. But I saw like on the Breakfast Club, they had these some Ethiopians on there. They're basically saying that there's like a genocide going on in Ethiopia.
Really?
But you know, I got like the firsthand knowledge of shit.
Yeah.
And it's like it's definitely some like Western spin going on in here. So basically, it's tribal over there, right? They have like a bunch of different tribes, right? And so there's like a tribe in like the northernmost part of Ethiopia, I believe, and they call it like the Tigray tribe, right?
Mm.
For like the past like 30 years, they controlled Ethiopia, like all of its resources. They had all the wealth, et cetera, et cetera. Until just recently, where they got like they have a new prime minister from another tribe who's been trying to, I don't want to say socialize the country, but basically just make it fair for the rest of the tribe, basically, right? And I guess it's been causing some conflict. And now what's going on, the Western world is basically looking at it and it's calling it a genocide, because the people that have ran Ethiopia and have all of the international connections are saying, hey, you're killing us. Help us. You understand what I'm saying?
So are they like...
It's like a Israel, it's basically like a Israel-Palestine situation. Low-key.
I didn't know about this at all.
Yeah.
About
so just look up Tigray genocide. Like that's what's going on right now. And from the viewpoint of like my girl who is of another, she's of another tribe, she's like, nah, that's not what's going on, like at all.
Oh, that's right. Sophia is.
Yeah, and it's like, in fact, what's happening is it's like not like we actually like trying to bring the nation back together.
Yeah,
it's like some kind of democracy essentially. But the people that was running this shit we don't get to run it no more, so now niggas is mad. Mm-hmm. And they want to fight. But guess what? They don't have enough to fight the rest of the country. You understand what I'm saying? So they basically losing. They basically losing the fight, but they calling it, and the media around the world is calling it a genocide of these people.
Hold on, I'm about to look this up. Get on Al Jazeera.
Yeah, it's a little. It's
a lot.
It's interesting to see how the news can be presented. You know what I'm saying?
Damn, killed 100 civilians. That's the first thing I've seen.
Yeah, man.
Holy shit.
Wow.
People like
want to
do stuff like that.
People are
that's
greedy.
Awesome. So but it's not even greedy. Like
that's what's going on around the world. You know what I mean? I also saw some shit, man. Did you guys see this fucking rat infestation that's going on in Australia right now?
No.
So basically like Australia's countryside.
You follow the BBC?
What?
You follow the BBC?
No, don't.
How the fuck did you know about rats in Australia?
Yo, man, I'm a world citizen, dog. I suggest you should do the same thing. Nigga, you got a passport, man, you feel me? I'm a world citizen. That's what you do. Like, we should care about issues outside of the world. So basically, what's happening?
Let me ask you this.
Australia's crops is at risk of like losing a whole like summer worth of crops or some shit like that because a bunch of rats in there. Shit, wicked.
Word, I'm gonna just start hitting you for world news. I was like, yo, let's go down to India.
World news.
Well, it's crazy that you ask.
I'm sorry. That is sad for the people in Australia. I don't care. But that's
why. I mean, it's interesting. It's just it interests me. That's what I'm saying. Like,
yeah,
they're like, oh, poor Australians. Nah, niggas be alright. It's okay. But I just find it very interesting that it's like, oh shit, we're overrun with bugs over here, but some niggas is overrun with rodents. Imagine that. Imagine if that was the case in Virginia, instead of cicadas, it was rats everywhere. Yeah, right.
Yeah, that'd be a big one.
Should respect it for you a little bit.
I scream every time I saw one. So,
nah, you'll eventually like.
No, that's not something that you get used to. Them things bad at you, yeah.
Exactly.
If you see, if I see 12 rats in a day, by the time I got to the 12th rat, I'm not screaming.
No, you're not. But bro, you're not rasping it. You're saying 12, nigga. Imagine seeing 1,200 every day.
Walk out and there's a whole like five families.
Imagine walking out onto the street and instead of seeing concrete, you see rats. That's what's going on.
Oh, it's like that.
Yes. Yes.
So what, they don't got no weaponry or nothing like that?
No, so here's what happened, right? So in the little ecosystem or whatever over there, they had like flooding, right? And it's regular that it floods and then it dries out, right? But apparently it's too hot because of global warming. It got too hot and the flooded like dried too quick, right? And so as a result, like it dried faster than the ecosystem could compensate for, right? So there's no natural predators there to get rid of the rats. So they just there. And now they fucking and rats breathe like crazy.
Yeah, they do.
They overrun that shit in like a matter of weeks. And now it's like, all right, well, yeah, we could kill them, but it's like them shits is in everything.
Yeah.
And they chew on everything. They get into the walls, they chew up all the wiring, they go into cars and chew up the wiring in your vehicles and all sorts of crazy shit, dog. Yeah, they eat everything. Yeah, nigga, yeah. You're gonna fuck with your head a little bit, ain't it? It's freaking out.
Team human, dog. I would get rid of all of them.
You said team human?
Yeah.
Did you see the lady that mollywopped the bear to save her dog?
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Help the bear. I think a lot of people do that with their
with their
dogs. But the thing is that
would you do it for your kid?
Would I do it for my kid? Yeah, absolutely. But the thing is,
question.
A lot of people save their dogs before they save their kids.
Mm-hmm.
Melissa, do you have a comment for that? Because you just spoke about this yesterday.
But if someone was attacking Iris, I mean, it's your adrenaline would pick up. I would definitely stick up for her.
She got fangs.
Yeah, she's got. That's a fucking bear.
Yeah, two animals.
Yeah, I'm out. Okay.
It doesn't matter.
You guys love dogs.
I do.
I don't know if I stayed on my kid, it'd be a whole thing.
If I had a kid, it'd probably be the kid, or because the dog will be able. A kid can't defend itself like a dog can.
Yeah,
that's what a gun is for.
Bella, I'm sick the fuck out of Bella.
Yo, I was watching Anaconda the other day.
That old ass movie.
Yeah,
CGI is awful in it.
Dog. And I'm like, wait, are anacondas this smart? That seems like a super snake that had human intelligence.
Nah. Like,
John Voight. Yo, something's bad about that fucking movie.
Yo, bro, you go back and watch a lot of older movies, you'd be like, this is garbage, bro. Yeah. You guys ever seen.
Yo, the 90s was a bad time, dude.
Yeah.
It was bad.
They were just trying shit.
That was a shitty period for cinematography, man. Period.
So was Congo. Congo was bad too. Remember that?
I gotta watch it again.
It was the super monkeys.
The super monkeys that were killing niggas in the jungle. Yeah.
I mean, we still got stinkers now. And you guys see The Quiet Place?
Yes.
No. Is it good?
I liked it.
This is just a silent movie, right?
No, not the whole time.
They talk.
You see the first one?
No, I have never seen this movie.
Okay, then watch the first. Don't even ask.
I'm talking about it.
So there's actual, like, they talk. Is dialogue in it?
Yeah.
Oh.
You get to speak a little bit, and the whole thing's not quiet.
I wish it was like Bird Box. Where it was like,
I was just going to say, is it like Bird Box?
Bird Box for talking. The whole thing, like, no, this is not as bad as that.
What was Bird Box? You can't look at them, right?
Yeah.
Bird Box was like, you can't open your eyes, then you open your eyes, and then, like, then you look at the sky, and then the sky makes you crazy on some M. Night Shyamalan shit.
That's exactly what that is.
The Happening?
The Happening is the worst movie I had ever seen in my life.
That was Bird Box. Except for your eyes instead of your nose.
That was pretty bad.
Yeah.
So The Quiet Place is the same thing. You just can't talk.
Yeah.
So, but they just writing notes to each other?
No, they used
to. I just went like this. the lady gave birth. She gave birth in The Quiet Place. They was like.
She screamed. Deter you from watching it. It's a good.
Were they telling the baby to be quiet? Were they shh in the baby?
Watch the first one. They were not shh in the baby. Don't listen to him.
So how to keep the baby quiet?
They didn't. The baby started yelling, and they had to run for their fucking lives.
After she just gave birth.
She gave birth and yelled while she was giving birth.
So what were they running from?
The creatures. Have you never seen it?
It was aliens. No, I've never seen
this movie. I'm not having this conversation with either one of you. None of you have seen the fucking movie.
This is what we do on the show. We talk about things we've never seen.
No.
And we make determinations on whether or not everyone else should go and see it.
They were running from birds and leaves.
No, it's like this little, it's like an alien creature type of thing that it listens with its good hearing.
Let me ask you something.
Like they hear stuff and shit is real disgusting.
Let me ask you something. Okay. If they try to throw a cup of water on it.
It's not a gremlin, nigga.
It's not gonna melt to pieces if it rains.
It worked on signs.
No.
You beat the shit out of one of them jumps with a baseball bat.
Yeah, he threw some water on it.
Since y'all will never see it, apparently. He uses like a sound device. Just one girl is deaf, so she has a hearing aid, and she uses like a little radio that makes like a screeching sound, and it puts up their ears.
And it blows their heads up.
When they do that whole shebang, then they shoot them.
Ah. Yo, you know another, so, all right, so we're doing a shitty movie section. You know the movie I saw recently that was shitty?
What?
The Angelina Jolie movie on HBO Max. Those That Wish Me Dead.
That was not good.
The movie fucking sucked.
What?
I was like, what the fuck does this movie have to do with her being a firefighter? Why is she so suicidal?
You watched that movie.
Yeah.
It was stupid?
That wasn't that bad.
That movie sucked.
I didn't think it was that bad. But no, it had nothing to do with her being a fire, except that she had PTSD about fires. That was it.
Yeah. They didn't really go into the background of like how it happened, why it happened, what really happened.
Why they kill your dad? Why they kill your dad? I want to know. They killed your dad at the beginning of the movie. Why they kill your dad, bro? He don't even know. He's just in the woods lost. How you just... Nah, son. Nah.
I don't watch enough movies.
Angelina Jolie get struck by lightning and live, nigga.
Oh, yeah, that was bullshit. I thought that was... Yeah, she did.
She got struck by lightning.
She got struck by lightning and, like, kept going.
Nigga.
Yes. Oh, just, like, on the wake-up? Like, she just
got
up.
Yeah, no. The kid was like, oh, get up, get up. And she got up, like, oh, let's go. The fuck?
This is why I don't be watching movies, bro, because shit like this.
You got to watch them to see if they're good or not.
Right.
Yo, nah, Mortal Kombat was better than that joke, bro.
What?
I enjoyed Mortal Kombat more than that shit.
Mortal Kombat was a good movie.
Mortal Kombat was good.
Yeah.
Shit.
You said Mortal Kombat was bad.
It was good.
It was good. Definitely you compared it to the first one. The second one, yeah. Without a doubt.
What?
It's a masterpiece compared to those.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is definitely a masterpiece compared to the others. You're right. You're right. You're right.
That's the last movie I watched? You are killing me with the smoke.
Sorry. Right in your face, right?
Ain't shit really coming out like that. No, that's some, they got a new Conjuring joint out. I was trying to get into that.
Oh, yeah. That's on HBO Max, too, today, right?
Yeah. I'm not really like... Horror films don't even scare me like that. I really want to watch like a scary movie that's going to scare me. And that shit,
you're an adult, bro.
Yeah, nothing's going to scare you. Because you know
Reality. Yeah, you...
You know what's scary? You know what movies be scaring me? Like them dystopian future movies. Because I'm like, yeah, this shit going to happen, bro. Like, yo, Book of Eli is a horror film.
That was so horror.
Like that. It's like,
man, you ain't ever walked in water.
You know it's a horror film? You ever seen Idiocracy?
That movie's great.
That's a horror film right there.
To you.
Because that, no, but that's where we're going.
You afraid of me. You afraid of President Camacho?
Yes. And I'm afraid that we'll be watering our plants with Gatorade.
I don't think we'll ever get to that point where we're... I mean, Donald Trump is going, so, you know.
We have life,
for 2 years. Just 2 years. That's it.
We can make it.
Just 2 years.
Facebook banned him for 2 years. He'll be back. Don't worry. He'll be right back.
He's banned on Facebook?
For 2 years. For 2 years, he'll be back.
Fuck politics. The baby sold it to Kamala Harris. What you feel about that?
Talking about what?
I saw a meme that had them sitting down on the seat, and it said, "What it said? Horny milk looks for BBC for young BBC." So with Kamala and little baby. I'm gonna say it like every 22-year-old that has no idea how the fucking world works and be like, oh, gotta start somewhere. At least he's having a conversation. He's having a conversation, Ken. That matters.
About what though?
The conversation.
Okay. Okay. The conversation that matters.
Better than Steve Harvey.
Yo, listen, man, what's up with Steve Harvey, man? What's up with Lori Harvey? What's up with Future Vandross?
You're just a cornball. Let's start there, okay? You're not about to put in a song, tell Steve Harvey I don't want her. My nigga, do you know anything about everybody? You gotta rap about everybody because we don't give a fuck.
But I mean, but
he heard it.
But who?
Here, Bella.
That's the thing.
She most definitely left that nigga for, what's her name, for this Drake rollout, so...
Oh,
I mean,
wait. So is she about to end up with Drake?
No, she. When they dead each other, when her and Michael B. Jordan, Stop beating. That's what certified lover boy drops.
Okay.
And then we're gonna get a motion picture of them doing mad cutesy shit. I told you, remember Ash? I'm on to it. I see it.
All right, that'll make you 1-for-2 on predictions.
Yes, my Playboy Cardi prediction was not the best prediction.
Wow. Who knew he would go from Artist of the Year to just deadbeat dad?
Yes, I know.
Who knew? I didn't see that coming.
Listen, I believed. I made you guys believe.
Yo, so is Coi Leigh Ray the best new artist of the year?
Is who?
Coi Leigh Ray. Purr.
Another question?
Yes.
Okay, do you think that she's artist of the year?
I don't know. Big Purr. She might be in the running.
Why is
she
that?
She might be in the running of artist of the year.
Yeah. Wow. Who best new artist of the year?
To me, like my
we're about halfway through, right?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of bangers ain't come out like that, truth be told. Who I like the most, right?
Nobody new like that, right?
Nah, who I like the most that's like considered super new to me, Sleepy Hollow, but he not that new.
I'm not hip to say.
You ever heard Two Souls?
Who?
You ever heard the song Two Souls?
Maybe.
That shit a vibe. When you driving to DC today, play that shit. Roll all your windows down. Telling you, make sure you got your shades on. Put on Two Souls. Ride very slow.
Moray?
Who?
Who?
I don't know.
Oh, Mooski?
Wait a second.
Who's that?
I am so sick of that sound.
Which one is that?
I think that's she's a runner, she's a track star.
That's not him though.
That's Mooski.
I don't know. I'm tired of that sound though. I had enough. We get it.
So Big Purr is artist of the year, new artist by default, bro.
Fuck no, not to me.
Not after what happened when she went and performed live. Big Purr.
What was she doing?
I feel bad. She tried to go do a concert and niggas wasn't fucking with her.
No, we're not.
So how is she artist of the year then? Or new best new artist?
I don't know. Rap caviar? I don't know.
Rap caviar.
I don't know, nigga. That's what I'm asking these questions, bro.
I don't know, rap caviar.
I don't know, dog.
Let me see what they talk about over there. Hell up. We got a playlist, nigga.
No, man. Who knows, man? I don't know. I'm just spitballing, you know what I'm saying?
Spitballing.
I can't figure it out, but
I just don't know how many new artists there really are.
How about this, man? We all got homework, man. We all got homework.
We all got homework, and we got to link up in the physical, man. This is another.
We're gonna record physically next week in person.
And where?
In person next week, we're gonna record.
Yes.
Yeah. Are you going to be here, Ash? What are you doing? Are you going out of town?
Exactly what I'm doing. And I don't know if you can make it here on a Friday evening, but that would personally work better for me. I am working an AAU regional track meet at Verina. And that'll literally be the majority of Saturday and Sunday.
That's the whole weekend, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Before we go, because I know we're about to wrap up, Ash, so you're not gonna train what's the name to be Jackie Jonah Kersey?
I can speak for the track world when I say we are all pissed the fuck off at Tiffany Haddish being classed about this. First of all, you need to at least get somebody who looks like her. Secondly, someone else is like, oh, she's been track before. Okay, but I can't, if you see a picture of FloJo and get inside a picture of Tiffany Haddish, I honestly can't imagine her being in cut-up shape. If she does, awesome. If she does not, it's not going to be the same at all.
Well, makeup, you know. Makeup changes all that.
You can fake the definition in the arm with makeup?
Nah, they're going to fake the mole.
Okay, that's one thing. I don't care about that. I care about the body and the track star herself. Like,
that's why you got to go. You got to go to Hollywood and train how to run good.
There were
You know, Ash got to. Ash, you got to do the You got to go when they do the Marion Jones jump.
That's what we're talking about.
I'm not saying that you was gonna keep these. I'm just saying.
No, I should go out for that. I was 13. Like her, but and I don't disagree necessarily. But Queen, you probably have no idea who she is. Queen Harrison, she could have done this job. Barber twins could have done this job.
Are these runners that you're talking about right now?
They are athletes.
They could have gave it to a they could have gave it to a real athlete and then been like, yo, act.
I mean, but bro, that's like, but was Ray Allen good and he got game?
It was all right.
Just be honest, man. Like, you don't just tell the athlete to go do it just because they look like
somebody. Could have got her. Could have got good old Queen. She could have been up in there.
Yo, speaking of that, this is a good little topic. Let's talk about female athletes. Let's talk about this real quick before we get out of here, because we'd be remiss if we didn't touch on this. Naomi Osaka.
Mm-hmm.
She dropped out of the French Open for mental health reasons.
Yeah.
More importantly, how the press can have negative effects on her mental health. How do we feel about this?
Yeah, she can do whatever the fuck she wants.
Yeah,
is she for that?
Yeah, absolutely. You don't have to. Sometimes, just people in their regular lives, sometimes you wake up and be like, I don't feel like going to work today. Yeah. And you're not sick.
Yes. And think about all of the bullshit interviews that basketball athletes continuously sit through and get asked dumbass questions. Well,
everybody gets asked dumb questions in interviews, even job interviews. Yeah. Why do you want this job? Are you going to ask me that stupid ass fucking question? Like, come on. It's a stupid question.
Well, here's what makes it a little different. And here's why I ask, right? Because if you ask me, I think she kind of had a crossroads where she kind of might have to consider retirement at this point. Here's why I say this. Listen. Here's why I say this, right? That's part of the rules of engagement with these professional leagues and shit. It's in these contracts that they signed. And it's also part of the French Open rules that she has to participate in the media after matches.
So she just
She said, I'm gonna take the fines, right? And they were like, okay, well, if you continue to not go and not go to the post game jumps, we're just gonna kick you out of the tournament. Yeah. That's what they told her.
Okay.
And so she said, all right, well, I'll do y'all one better. Instead of making this a big ass distraction, I'm just going back out.
Yeah.
Fuck y'all. Basically. Yeah. And she's saying, I'm going to take some time away from tennis, period.
Okay.
Now, so if you're the WTA, the Women's Tennis Association, do you change every single tournament now and say, all right, well, if you don't want to talk, that you're exempt? If you have a mental health condition? Like, where's the line with that? That's why.
Cam, do you want to go first?
You go, Ash. You go.
Well, okay. It definitely matters if she said she wasn't going to do an interview ever again, right? Like, that's one thing. If she's having an off week or month or whatever, and she don't feel like fucking talking, I think she gets to not talk. She gets to withdraw herself. That's what it is. You're right. It's completely different if you don't want to do one ever again, because at that point, okay, what are you going to do? Because there are rules everywhere. But if this is only in regards to the French Open, fuck the French Open then. Just don't participate in it. We all know that you're already the best in the world. We know that.
Nah, I mean, did you guys read what she, did you guys see what she put out?
Yeah.
She said she's been dealing with this depression like from since like 2018.
That makes a lot of sense. Came in so young. And it's interviews constantly. And they're like, oh, do you think you're going to beat this person who's 20 years older than you? And
that's what I'm saying.
Just play. Back the fuck up. So I understand.
But this is why I say, like, when I see this, and for her to, like, openly admit, like, yo, I struggle with this shit a lot, I could recently see this girl saying, yo, I'm done. She done made however many millions of dollars.
Yeah.
She's like, you know what? Fuck this. good. Because, like, you see, we see the guys, you know, the guys and girls that have, like, social anxiety, but they pro athletes, but they have to talk to the media. I don't know if you remember, what's the dude's name? He's played football, Ricky Williams. The nigga that retired so he could smoke pack. His first post-game news conference, you know, he did that shit with his helmet on, right?
Yeah.
He did it with his helmet and the dark visor on. Yeah. He scared of everybody.
I remember that.
I picture that. Yo, that shit, nah, that's like, it's, I don't know, man. It's something to behold. I think all professional, like, leagues need to look at that. I think they because me, I was talking to somebody else about, like, I think that shit is some bullshit that we make these niggas sit down and talk about what they just went through. Especially if they just lost or if he got injured or some bullshit happened. Like,
it's a societal thing across the board. Yo, bro, if I don't feel like talking to you today, that's my damn right to not talk to you today.
Right.
If I want to talk to you, I'll talk to you. Why don't get all of these cameras in my face? This and the third. I think the fact that they let in, there's so many fucking news outlets and it's 20 motherfuckers sitting by your locker. It's like, yo, bro, that's too much.
Right.
It can be maybe you don't have 20 people. Maybe it's one or two. Something. You know what I mean?
Now that shit's exacerbated by like a hundred because I could get a press pass and be like,
but that's what I'm saying. Anybody just get access to it, just like with the paparazzi. Like, yo, so they'll be wrong to punch somebody in their face because they don't want to have like pictures. Like, I'm still a private. Yeah, I may be a public figure, but really, I'm still a private citizen at the end of the day.
Yeah.
What I do in my day to day is not your business, and you don't need to know my thoughts on everything. I don't give a fuck what your writer says.
Right.
If she went, I stand with her to go like, yo, I don't want to do this. Nah, fuck y'all. I'm not doing this shit. I don't feel like talking. So nah, you know what then, Queen? Don't talk. Fuck it.
I just think that shit is.
And fuck the French Open
But you know what's so wild about that shit, though? You know what's wild about that? One of the other women that was in the tournament, she had to withdraw from the tournament as well. You know why? She hurt her ankle at the post-match interview.
Mm-hmm.
Think about the irony in that.
She's not as big as Osaka, so.
No matter, but bro, she twisted her ankle. She got physically injured trying to fulfill a media obligation. Not playing tennis.
It's
just showing you how bullshit this shit is and get rid of that shit. It's stupid.
Yeah, it's stupid. Obviously, I'm not there, so I don't know what it is like to be on that day to day, nor do I deal with that on the day to day.
But check this out, right? Me and you were in a tournament, right? And I said, I'm not doing this tournament no more because I don't fuck with y'all media. Mm-hmm. You stay in the tournament because you're like, whatever, I can do the media, it's no problem, right? And then you twist your ankle. Now we both out the tournament because of the fucking media.
I mean, but in my case, that would probably be happenstance more so than I.
It's just ironic. That's all.
If you don't feel like talking, don't talk. Even with that said, don't be a person that never wants to fucking talk.
I'm just here so I don't get fined. What happened to that?
Yeah. And I love doing Marshawn Lynch.
You can do that everywhere. Like, I'm just saying, so I don't get fired. I'm just here to talk about media obligation and whatever the fuck.
What you want to talk about? I'm here to just try to get fired.
Nigga, what you want to talk about? Same thing you're talking about.
Then you go, you're
a little roaster and get the fuck on.
Yeah, you got it. That's it? 5 minutes? That's good?
All right. Y'all got it? But,
I don't have to speak to you. And I think that's dumb that leagues even have obligations for that. That doesn't make any sense. I don't need to speak to you if I don't want to.
I mean, bro, it's all part of the business.
Sure, but it's an obligation, bro?
Yes.
That's school, bro? Are you obligated to come to this?
Yeah, it's crazy, right?
Fuck no.
It's crazy, right?
But yo, and as much as I'm saying fuck no and all that stuff, yeah, I like people that's gonna be like, buck the system, nigga, fuck it. I'm not doing that shit.
So you do it with Kyrie. And that's a good way to end this episode. You know what I'm saying? Episode 40.
No, the Kyrie thing way more delicate. The Kyrie thing way more delicate, bro. Because Kyrie say the mental health shit and then he'll perpetuate something like that too.
All right.
My fault. Osaka just saying y'all don't want to talk, and she not talking. Look.
No, but she. All right.
Take your mental health break. Yeah. Ooh. Kyrie, like, I need a mental health break. All right, and then it'd be just a week, like, oh, one day, and they come back and they do all types of shit, and they'd be like, oh, it's too much. I gotta take a break. Bro, what you gonna listen? You taking a break or you not taking a break?
Yo, he stomped on Lucky, bro.
Yeah, I don't give a fuck. It's a imaginary.
Ash, y'all some Celtics fans. He stepped on Lucky Ash.
I actually don't care about that.
No, it was freezing up, and I didn't hear what he said at all.
He said he what?
He said he what?
He saw on Lucky's face.
Okay, both of y'all are talking. Both of y'all are talking. Stop. One person out of here.
I said, ain't your people Celtics fan?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Kyrie stepping on Lucky. Like, that's disrespect. Nah.
Just a little bit. It is.
Yo, listen.
Was it enough for like big baby Davis to threaten violence?
Yo, bro, let me ask you this. I'll crip you blood.
Okay.
I see a red flag on the floor. Stomp on that shit.
Sure.
What's your reaction?
We got problems.
Yeah, all right then. Thank you.
For sure. All right. Okay. All right. Well then. Let's do a more accurate
representation,
right? Okay. Let's just say this. Right. I'm Chris. You blood. Right. But at one point or another, you were also Latin King, MS-13, a fucking Peace Stone Nation, Gangsta Disciple, and I step on any of those flags. And I step on your gangster disciple flag or whatever. You want it's a problem?
Nah, I ain't gangster disciple no more.
That's big baby Davis right there, nigga. You was on every team, nigga. You talking about the Celtics? KG, you was a fucking Timberwolf half your life. You talking about the Celtics? Fuck out of here, nigga.
You want to chip with them? That's the only reason why you're talking about
that. Man, fuck that. And then on top of that, y'all kicking for these racist ass motherfuckers up in Boston. In Boston, you shitting me? With the own fans stab Paul Pierce?
Yo, listen.
Y'all want to cape for these niggas?
Yo, listen.
Episode 40 Knicks Coke. That's all we care about, nigga.
Fuck Trae Young. Spit on Trae Young next year, too. Fuck Trae Young.
Fuck all of that, man.
Knicks Coke. We out of here, man. It's episode 40. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Oh, nigga, if you see me anywhere, just know it's Nick's coat, nigga.
Yeah. Fuck Lucky.